गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस सम इम्पोर्टेंट फॉर्मूला एंड वी विल ऑल्सो सॉल्व सम न्यूमेरिकल्स प्रॉब्लम. ओके, सो हियर इज सम इम्पोर्टेंट फॉर्मूला. बिफोर न्यूमेरिकल्स यू हैव टू लर्न ऑल दी ऑल द फॉर्मूलाज बिकॉज दी ऑल आर वेरी इम्पोर्टेंट. सो योर फर्स्ट फॉर्मूला इज केपलर्स थर्ड लॉ. It is t square upon r cube is equal to k. K is the constant. T is the period of revolution. Small r is the mean distance between sun and the planet. Newton's universal law of gravitation, that is F is equal to g m1 m2 upon d square or r square. F is the force between two masses. M1 and M2, G is the universal gravitational constant. Its value is 6.67 into 10 raised to minus 11 Newton meter square per kg square. Okay? M1, M2 is the masses of the object. D is the distance between two masses. G is equal to G M upon R square. G is the acceleration due to gravity. Again, G is the gravitational constant, universal gravitational constant. M is the mass of the planet. R is the radius of the planet. Okay? Newton's equation of motion. Newton's first equation of motion is V is equal to U plus AT. Here is AT. Newton's second equation of motion is S is equal to S is equal to ut plus half at square. Newton's third equation of motion is v square is equal to u square plus 2as. But in case of free fall, Newton's equation of motion becomes at the place of a. In case of free fall, at the place of A, you have to put G. A is replaced by G. And U is equal to 0. So, if you put U is equal to 0, and if you put A is equal to G, this V will be equal to GT. Newton's second equation of motion will become S is equal to half GT square. Similarly, Newton's third equation of motion becomes V square is equal to 2GS. Okay? Fifth, GPE, that is gravitational potential energy, is equal to negative minus. Here is minus. Minus G capital M small m upon R plus S. Again, capital G is the universal gravitational constant. M is the mass of the planet. Small m is the mass of the object. R is the radius of the planet. H is the height from the planet. H is the height from the surface of the planet. Okay, small h. V escape, ESC, is equal to under root 2GR. And if you put G is equal to GM upon R square, this equation V escape will be equal to under root 2. At the place of G, what you have to put? GM upon R square into R. R cancel. So V escape will be equal to 2GM upon R. Okay? So it depends on questions whether you have to use this formula to find escape velocity or this formula or this one. It depends on numericals. Seventh one, W. W is the weight. Weight is nothing. Weight is the force, gravitational force, is equal to mg. M is the mass, g is the acceleration due to gravity. And eighth number, I am writing it here. Eighth number. This is important for numericals. If you throw a ball vertically upper direction, in this case take G नेगेटिव, जी इज इक्वल टू माइनस जी. रिमेंबर, ऑलवेज रिमेंबर, इफ यू थ्रो अ बॉल और एनी ऑब्जेक्ट वर्टिकली अपवर्ड, इन दैट केस जी इज इक्वल टू माइनस जी. ओके, एंड इफ एन ऑब्जेक्ट कमिंग डाउन, इन दिस केस जी इज इक्वल टू प्लस जी. दिस इज इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर न्यूमेरिकल्स, ऑलवेज रिमेंबर. इफ यू थ्रो अ बॉल वर्टिकली अपवर्ड, टेक जी एज नेगेटिव माइनस जी, एंड इफ अ बॉल इज मूविंग डाउनवर्ड, इन दैट केस टेक जी एज पॉजिटिव. ओके, सो नाउ वी विल सॉल्व फॉर न्यूमेरिकल्स. सो यू प्लीज ओपन योर टेक्स्ट बुक. सो चैप्टर नंबर 1 दैट इज ग्रेविटेशन, क्वेश्चन नंबर 2 डी, दिस इज इंपॉर्टेंट. ओके, सो इन दिस न्यूमेरिकल्स व्हाट यू हैव टू डू, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल रीड द क्वेश्चंस एंड ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज गिवन डेटा. ओके, so a stone thrown vertically upward with initial velocity u, initial velocity is u, this is a height h. So if you want to make the diagram, so diagram, say this is ground. So here is an object. This object is thrown vertically upper direction with initial velocity u. So u is the initial velocity of the object. This is ground, okay? And reaches a height of h. Say this object came here at the height h. So h is equal to how much? H is given. This is given. So tell me one thing. Here is initial velocity u. After some time, this object will come in rest. So in that case, final velocity v will be equal to 0. Because after, if I throw this marker vertically upper direction, at the maximum height, this will come in the rest. Since that this marker came in the rest, so final velocity v will be equal to 0 here. And since this is going upper direction, so here g, you have to take minus g. At the place of g, what you have to put? G at the place, you have to put minus g. Understood? Show that time taken to go up, say here is time taken is t1. How much time taken? t1 is the time taken to go from here to here, that is called time of ascending. Show that time taken to go up is same as the time taken to come down. It means, say this is, if an object took 10 seconds to go maximum height, 10 seconds. So you have to prove that, show that whenever this object will come down from here to here on the surface of earth, again it will take same time, that is 10 seconds. Okay, that you have to prove. So write first of all given data. Given observe this diagram and write the given data. Given initial velocity initial velocity is equal to u. Final velocity zero. Acceleration due to gravity g is equal to minus g, right? Displacement s is equal to h. Okay, to show that time taken to go up is same as time taken to come down. So don't try to find. In this question, you have to show time of ascending. Say this is time t1. Time of ascending is t1. To show. Time of ascending t1 is equal to time of descending, say t2 is equal to I'm writing here time of descending that is t2. Say t1 t2 formula used formulas. In this numericals, we will use two formula. First one, v square is equal to u square plus 2gs. Second, v is equal to u plus gt. Understood? Now solution. For upward motion, right here for upward motion, it means object is going in upward direction. So in this case, g is equal to minus d. T is equal to t1, here is t1. V is equal to 0 and s is equal to h. Okay, first of all for upward motion and then for downward motion. So since v square is equal to u square plus 2gs, v is equal to how much? 0 for upward motion. At highest point v will be equal to 0. So 0 is equal to u square. Here is, and one more thing, that here u is equal to u. Here initial velocity
is u. U square plus 2g. At the place of g, you have to put minus g. So here will minus g into, at the place of s, that is h. So 0 is equal to u square plus into minus minus 2gh. So if you bring this left hand side, then this will be equal to 2gh is equal to u square, or we can write here u square is equal to 2gh. So u will be equal to under root 2gh, equation number 1. Now we will use this formula. Now v is equal to u plus gt, but v is equal to, for upward motion, v is equal to 0, or you can write 0. At the place of u, write u plus g. At the place of g, you have to put minus g, because we are doing the calculation for upward motion, and for upward motion we take minus g. At the place of g, put minus g. T is t1. See, t is the time of ascending. So 0 will be equal to u plus into minus minus g t1. So if you bring this left hand side, then this will be equal to g t1 is equal to u. So therefore t1 is equal to u upon g. So therefore t1 is equal to u is equal to how much? Under root 2gh. So at the place of u, right? Under root 2gh. And here is g. Equation number 2. Okay? This is for upward motion. This is for upward motion. Now for downward motion, what will happen? For downward motion, this is important, okay? So if you will understand this one, then for downward motion you will do the calculation. Now see, this is ground. Now object is here. So in this case, u will be equal to 0, because after reaching maximum height, they will come at rest and they will fall down. So in that case, here is object in rest. So in this case, u is equal to 0. Okay, in downward motion, now u will be equal to 0 and g will be equal to plus g, since now object is moving in downward direction. So g is equal to plus g. And again, s is equal to h, because this is s is equal to h, and here v is equal to v time t. Say this is, in this case, time of ascending is t1. Now time of descending is, say this is t is equal to t2. Okay? So, just a second, I will erase the board. For downward motion, I
Again we will use this formula. V square is equal to V square plus 2gh and V is equal to u plus gt. So since V square is equal to V square is equal to u square plus 2gs, V square is equal to, at the place of V we have to put V. So V square is equal to u square. So in this case u is equal to 0. 0 square means 0 plus 2g plus g, that is 2g. S is equal to how much? H. So right here H. So V square will be equal to 2gh. Equation number 3. Now again we will use second formula. Now V is equal to u plus gt. So at the place of V, write V here, u. For downward motion, u is equal to 0. So write here 0 plus g. G, at the place of G, put G, T. At the place of T, we have to put T2, that is time of descending. That is time taken to reach the object to the ground, that is T2. So V is equal to G T2. So here T2 will be equal to V upon G. T2 will be equal to V upon G. So T2 will be equal to V is equal to how much? Oh, just a second. So here, therefore, V will be equal to under root 2GH. Equation number 3. So at the place of V, we can put under root 2GH. So at the place of V, we can put here under root 2GH upon G. This is equation number 4. See, T1 is equal to how much? T1 is equal to under root 2GH upon G. T2 is equal to under root 2GH upon G. So both are same. So from equation, T1 is what? T1 is time taken by an object to reach maximum height. T2 is what? T2 is time taken by an object to reach the ground. So both are same. That is, time of ascending T1 is equal to time of descending T2. So we can write from equation 2 and 4. From equation 2 and 4, I will erase the board here, okay? So from equation 2 and 4, time of ascending T1 is equal to time of descending T2. Hence proved. I hope you understood. Okay. So now next questions we will do. Question number 4 is also important. So question number 4, this is important. Let the period of revolution of a planet at a distance r from a star be t. It means, say this is star and this is planet. The star, that is Sun. Here is any planet. Period of revolution. Let the period of revolution of a planet at a distance r. At a distance r from this star is t. Period of revolution of this planet is t. When the distance between planet and star is r. If it was at the distance of 2r. Now, in second case, this is case 1. Case 1. Case 2, distance became twice 2r, that is, say this is star, this is planet. Now this is 2r, this is planet P. Mr. Its period of prove that if it was at a distance of 2r from this star, its period of revolution will be, say, T dash is the period of revolution for second case. This is case second. T dash is the period of revolution when the distance between planet and star is 2r. This will be equal to how much? This will be equal to under root 8t. Under root till here and t. So we have to prove t dash will be equal to how much? Under root 8t. This we have to find. Okay? So first of all, write given. Observe this. After observing this diagram, you have to write given. Write here given. Given. Distance between planet from star is r. Given. Distance. Of planet from a star is equal to how much? R is given. So if you make the diagram, then it is very easy to write given data. Okay, that's why I prefer to draw the diagram. Distance of a planet from a star is how much? R. Period of revolution. Period of revolution is equal to T. New distance between planet and star is 2r. New distance between planet and star is equal to 2r. Okay? To prove a given period of revolution for new case or revolution period of revolution of planet is equal to how much? Period of revolution of planet, that is t dash equal to under root 8 and t. Period of revolution of planet, t dash equal to how much? Under root 80. This you have to prove. It means we have to solve, and finally we will find that t dash will be equal to under root 80. Okay, to prove.
in formula used. Formula used. T square upon R cube is equal to K. K is a constant. Okay? Then solution. Case 1. Since T square upon R cube is equal to K. So case 1, T is at the place of T square, no problem. At the place of R, we have to write capital R cube is equal to K, equation number 1. For case 2, case 2, again, since T square upon, we know that, since means we know that, T square upon R cube is equal to K, at the place of T, in second case, at the place of T, we have to put T dash equal to R cube, that is, here is R is 2R, that is 2R cube, 2R cube upon is equal to K. So now I will erase, okay? T dash square. So T dash square upon 2 cube, that is 8 R cube is equal to K. This is equation number 2. Now dividing equation 2 by equation 1. Dividing equation 2 by 1. 2, that is T dash square upon 8R cube. Divide, this is main line. Okay, main line. That is equation 1 is T square upon R cube. Here will be equal to, don't write equal to here, equal to, equation 2 was K, here is K, upon equation 1 K cancel. So we can write here T dash square upon 8R cube into, this will be, come here, R cube upon, this is T square is equal to 1 upon 1. R cube cancel. So therefore T dash square into, here is 1. So T dash square is equal to upon 8 T square is equal to 1 upon 1. Cross multiplication, T dash square into 1, that is T dash square is equal to 8 T square into 1, that is 8 T square. So T dash will be equal to under root 8 T square. So therefore T dash will be equal to under root 8, under root is still 8 and T outside the under root. So therefore T dash is equal to under root 8T. So this we had, we actually
in the questions what we have to prove, we have to prove period of revolution when distance between planet and any star is 2 hour. In that case, period of revolution t dash will be equal to how much? Under root 8t. So t dash equal to under root 8t. Okay. So in the language we have to write here. So in the language, hence its period of revolution will be under root 8t if distance between planet and star becomes 2 hour. So in the next lecture we will continue numericals. Okay, one more lecture I will take and then I will start next chapter. Okay, it is classification of element. Thank you.